Hello, I'm Lauren Green for FoxNews.com. There is growing outrage after a U.S. military official on Thursday outlined plans to retake the key Iraq city of Mosul from Islamic State terrorists as early as April. Is this revelation giving ISIS a heads up on future battle plans? Joining us with reaction is Pulitzer Prize-winning investigative reporter, author, and Fox News contributor Judy Miller. Hey, Judy, how are you doing?
Hi, Lauren. How are you?
All right, so announcing our plans. No element of surprise there, really. Bad move?
Well, every military person that I've talked to this morning, the steam was coming out of the top of their heads. I mean, you heard General Jack Keane, retired General Jack Keane, complain about this specifically, saying he had never heard of this kind of notice of an American military operation. That normally what one does is, you know, what the U.S. government does is sometimes they brief reporters a couple of days in advance, but then that information is tightly embargoed. However, apart from military people, I think there is an explanation that's being offered by the White House and by supporters of this government, and it is one that we can argue about, but at least it's coherent, and that is that this is part of the administration's PSYOPs, psychological warfare campaign against ISIS, because it's telling them that the United States and its allies are going to be moving against them. Mm-hmm. And this is aimed at dividing those who may have some doubts about remaining with ISIS from the main group and getting them to quit the fight before it begins. There's a second explanation which is given, and that is that it also gives civilians a chance to get out before the fight begins. Now, military people will say overwhelmingly that this is not enough of a reason to discuss one's military plans well in advance, because what you do is you're giving ISIS the opportunity to bury IEDs, to prepare defenses that could actually wind up getting more people killed than you would have ordinarily. So there is a robust debate about this issue.
I mean, I'm no military expert, but I would guess that the element of surprise is key in any kind of major battle.
Right, but I think at this point the ISIS understands that Mosul is going to be a focus of allied coalition efforts. I mean, they must take back this hugely important second largest city in Iraq. And ISIS can see what's going on around them. The Peshmerga fighters have been trying to isolate the towns and villages around Mosul to clear the way and to make sure that they can put their own fighters in there to block ISIS's flight when this fight begins. My question, and I think one that we're going to spend a lot of time looking at before April, when this is supposed to begin, is: are the Iraqi Sunni army components of the Iraqi army really ready to fight? I mean, we're now training roughly, they say, 3,000 of them for this fight, but will they be ready, and will they have the support of the local people within Mosul? Because unless you have Sunnis in Mosul, Sunni Iraqis, ready to support the government of Baghdad, this fight will have been for nothing, because they will rejoin ISIS as soon as American forces, because supposedly we're not going to be there, though I think we will be, but as soon as the Iraqi army retakes the city. You must have a political solution as well as a military solution to what's happening in Iraq.
Well, one of the things that I questioned, though, and I think the military experts I questioned as well, is it's one thing to telegraph that you're coming, right? But it's another thing to telegraph the timing and the number of units. Doesn't that spell disaster in terms of how the ISIS armies and military, they can prepare?
I didn't hear a good explanation, or let me put it this way, a convincing explanation for that. I don't understand telegraphing that kind of information so far in advance. I mean, if you can say that this is going to be a very serious campaign, that the United States will be supporting it in a variety of ways, we still don't know, by the way, the extent to which there will be American boots on the ground accompanying Iraqi forces. We don't know whether or not they're necessary, but I don't understand the need to be as specific as the Pentagon was on Thursday about American plans, but I'm not a military expert. I do know the region. I do know that until you solve the problem of the alienation of Iraq's Sunni population, that 20-25% of the people who don't consider the government in Baghdad their own, who consider it part of Iran, you can even retake Mosul and not solve the problem. But an essential ingredient is retaking territory that ISIS has taken so that you can signal to them their movement and their would-be followers, this is not an unstoppable, invincible machine. You have to do that. So whether or not we needed to telegraph it, I think this is going to continue to be the source of tremendously heated and an important debate.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, thank you very much, Judy Miller, for being on FoxNews.com. For more on the fight against ISIS, stick with FoxNews.com. I'm Lauren Green, and thanks for watching.